say, oh, yes, Brad Armstrong is good, but his daddy is in the way. But I'll tell you the truth. Now that I'm really looking at it, I really don't think that either one of them have a clue what's going on. I don't think that they're good as a team. I think Brad is just a sniveling little brat. I think that daddy's just somewhere to help him that obviously got no guts, pulled himself out of the match. And I'm personally, being the true professional that I am and the man of quality that I am, it hurts me to see this. It hurts me to see this kind of stuff on Georgia Championship Wrestling, because I keep myself to the highest, and I expect the people around me...
Wait a second.
Well, Luger, because I'm sick and tired of this junk here, so, yeah, don't let him hold you back. Come on, don't let him hold you back. I'm sick and tired of this. I'll tell you what, you see, this is a prime example of this.
Whoa! And it's Bob Armstrong chasing Rod Piper into the ring. Brad, Bob Armstrong, and we've got total chaos and bedlam broken loose here. Brad Armstrong hurtle out the ring, the bell is rung, and it is Rod Piper and Brad and Bob Armstrong battling away. We've got to get some order restored, and we've got all kinds of chaos and bedlam here, and we've got the ring filling up with people trying to separate these two, and it is Armstrong just caught Piper. There you see Ole Anderson, Rick Harris. Everybody's trying to pull Rod Piper out of there, trying to pull Bob Armstrong apart. And they're trying to get him stripped. And there goes Piper again, back into action. And you talked about it. We can't describe it all. There's too much happening here. And Bob Armstrong again breaks free, and now he's after Piper. Again, they're trying to pull Piper out of the ring. And it finally happened as I knew it was going to. It just had to happen. You can't take volatile tempers like that and not expect it to completely and totally explode. And that's exactly what happened there. Bob Armstrong had finally taken all that he could take. And Rod Piper finally, I think, felt cornered enough, or else felt brave enough, because Armstrong was being held or whatever. But nonetheless, he ripped off his jacket and his shirt and went to the fray. And we had a Pier 6 Donnybrook going in that ring, the likes of which I haven't seen in a long, long time.